Good evening. Thank you for coming in our talk. We try to discuss with or share something what Taring Padi doing. My name is Mohammad Yusof, and short name is friends call me Ucup. It's more short from Yusof, so it's more easier. So friend call me Ucup. And this is my friends. It's kind of like I'm the first generation in Taring Padi, and Yunan is second generation in Taring Padi. So before Taring Padi is kind of like a formal institution. When we starting, we have like a structure or something, because in that time it's like political issue in Indonesia is more, is really, the temperature is really, really hot after Suharto done, because many organization wake up from left and from right, try to wake up and try to having big mass, big people or something like that. So I think we starting to looking our first movies. Who's a friend from Australia make these movies for television in there, but it's nice movies for me. But this is where we still stay in our squad. Our squad is ex our campus. Where the campus gone, this place is empty, so we occupying that space for how start thing Taring Padi begin, and we stay in there 5 years, and then government and the royal want to take it, that space again. So let me see the movies first.
Near the ancient Buddhist temple of Borobudur in central Java, Indonesia, lies the cultural capital of Yogyakarta. A centre for the arts and education, Yogyakarta is also home to the political arts movement Taring Padi.
Kami adalah politik artis, karena politik artis sangat penting di Indonesia, dan kami kadang-kadang punya motto art, activism, and rock and roll. Di mana lembaga itu didirikan di Yogyakarta pada tanggal 21 Desember 1998. Baru saja Presiden Suharto dijatuhkan oleh gerakan mahasiswa dan rakyat.
Kami selalu bertemu setiap malam, ngobrol, kemudian kita mencoba membuat diskusi-diskusi dan mengundang kawan-kawan yang lainnya di luar wilayah kesenian gitu ya. Akhirnya kami memutuskan untuk membuat sebuah wadah bagi kami sendiri, yaitu sebuah lembaga budaya kerakyatan Taring Padi. Dengan orientasi bahwa seni yang akan kami perjuangkan atau gerakan seni yang akan kita lakukan adalah bagaimana membuka ruang-ruang demokrasi di antara masyarakat untuk memajukan masyarakat itu bersendiri.
Formerly students of the Indonesian Institute of Art, the founders of the movement had been on the front line of anti-Suharto demonstrations for years, calling for democracy, civil freedom, and an end to state violence and corruption.
98 juga ya, itu ketika kita masih keras-kerasnya menurunkan Suharto, saya menjadi keamanan, bagian keamanan dan koordinator lapangan di sebuah demonstrasi. Saya bagian set depan sendiri ya, bagian depan sendiri untuk buat untuk demonstrasi besar, langsung berhadapan dengan militer, itu selalu situasinya sangat berbahaya karena sniper itu bisa menembak dari arah mana saja dan itu harus siap mati itu ya. Itu jelas itu.
But when the regime fell, it didn't bring with it the reforms the students fought for.
Kita antusias membuat patung pembakaran Suharto waktu itu juga di UGM dengan teman-teman aktivis yang lain. Setelah itu mulai surut, ya teman-teman merasa, teman banyak-banyak aktivis yang merasa setelah menurunkan Suharto itu selesai, finish. Reformasi silakan berjalan gitu ya. Ternyata enggak gitu.
The reformasi was not revolution. Policies changed, but the political structures remained. Most of the old guard was still in power. The response of the more radical members of the protest movement was to form Tarang Padi and continue the reformation struggle. In the mid-1990s, in an effort to suppress student activism, Suharto had closed inner-city universities, relocating them to the outer suburbs. The newly formed Tarang Padi moved into the abandoned art school.
Mereklaim menduduki tempat ini. Kemudian kami kembangkan ini sebagai tempat mobilisasi dan belajar tentang belajar bersama-sama tentang seni yang berpihak kepada rakyat. Juga kami membuka diri untuk menjadi seni urban. Tidak hanya orang ISI, tapi teman-teman dari UGM, ada yang dari anak jalanan dan sebagainya. Satu yang harus kami taati yaitu ini sebagai tempat berproses untuk kerja, kerja kesenian maupun kerja-kerja yang lainnya. Kami merasa senang di sini, tapi entah di masa mendatang apakah kami akan tetap di sini atau tidak. Ketika ini harus diambil oleh pemerintah ataupun pihak-pihak swasta, kapital.
Hai, ini kantor atau tempat ruang untuk mencetak grafis, poster secara manual. Ini biasa cetakan kami ini biasa kami tempelkan di jalanan dan dimanapun teman-teman kami yang membutuhkan. Juga kadang-kadang kami mencetak untuk kami jual untuk menghidupi organisasi kami.
Terlihat yang selalu dikerjakan terutama yang sudah berjalan secara kontinu ialah menerbitkan komik buku bergambar yang berisikan gambar-gambar dan tulisan tentang demokrasi, tentang perlunya demokrasi, dan itu dibagi secara gratis. Biasanya setiap bulan diterbitkan, itu yang sudah kontinu, dan dibagi di setiap warung-warung kecil.
Media yang sering dipakai di kawan-kawan di Tarang Padi biasanya sangat sederhana, ya sangat umum gitu ya, sangat sering ditemui sehari-hari, seperti bullfoin, konte, ya dengan medium kertas, kanvas, dan biasa kita sering memakai cat untuk melukis, cat genteng, dan itu cukup bagus ya untuk membuat gambar dengan biaya yang ekonomis, nggak terlalu mahal, mudah dicari, dan saya pikir mudah untuk eksplorasi.
Intensif dengan pulpen karena aku merasa mudah didapat ketika ya di mana aja kita lewat warung kita bisa beli pulpen dan menggambar tembok atau buku kawan bisa ya itu hanya simple aja aku senang dengan itu.
Cerita di karya saya yang ini menceritakan tentang persoalan negara yang masih cukup besar mempengaruhi kondisi masyarakat yang secara real, secara nyata
seperti militer yang masih membatasi gerak rakyat, masyarakat yang di bawah yang jelas-jelas banyak penderitaan saat itu sampai sekarang.
Seni berpengaruh besar pada politik, dan aku percaya karena aku basic belajarku dari seni dan aku tahu banyak dan sedikit banyak tahu tentang seni. Segala perubahan di negeri ini akan terjadi dan akan jadi revolusi. Siapa yang menggerakkan kalau bukan dari orang-orang art?
Karena buat aku seni itu semacam tempayan gitu ya, wadah gitu, wadah besar yang bisa dimasuki oleh apa saja. Baik dari ekonomi, biologi, dari kimia, fisika, biologi, science, humanitarian, ya. Bisa masuk di dalam tempayan itu digodok dan munculnya adalah seni gitu.
Seni modern di sini ialah seni yang sudah terkontaminasi. Seni yang sudah digunakan untuk salah satu alat penguat penindasan orang-orang berkuasa, orang-orang yang mencari kekuasaan.
Setelah pasca gerakan seni rupa baru, itu Indonesia tidak punya gerakan kesenian. Ya, gerakan seni rupa baru. Kita akhirnya punya kesimpulan, harus ada dua. Satu gerakan kesenian kerakyatan, yaitu kemudian yang berpihak benar-benar kepada rakyat. Kemudian yang satu adalah gerakan benar-benar nihilisme. Aku milih yang pertama, gitu. Karena aku melihat situasi masyarakatnya tertinggal dari gerakan perkembangan kesenian, seni rupa pada umumnya lebih luas lagi. Terus aku memang pengen selalu dekat kesenianku, ekspresi kesenianku dekat dengan masyarakat.
Ada satu keuntungan yang kami miliki karena kami bergerak karena kami adalah gerakan kebudayaan bahwa semua yang kami suarakan semua yel-yel yang kami teriakkan kita memakai sebuah bentuk yang lain yaitu seni.
Kami punya komunitas dan punya kesepakatan bahwa sebuah komunitas tanpa musik itu akan mati.
Aku memilih musik punk, hardcore, semacam itu. Karena aku mendapatkan kebebasan.
Using recorded and live music to get their message across, Tarang Padi's punk band Black Boots and electronic band Techno Shit play to audiences around Indonesia.
Itu sangat menjadi prioritas utama bahwa acara musik adalah tempat kita untuk berpropaganda.
Ketika seperti di Indonesia sendiri, masih banyak harus kita melawan terus. Kami hanya sebatas lirik atau main di atas panggung dengan publik. Kami percaya bahwa perubahan itu akan ada.
The same inventiveness and subversion is brought to bear in their street protests.
Kami belajar dari demonstrasi yang ada di Indonesia ya. Ketika kita hanya aksi massa dengan berjalan long march gitu ya. Akhirnya masyarakat mempunyai kejenuhan-kejenuhan yang akhirnya seperti menjadi apolitis gitu ya. Tapi ketika kita memakai baju yang namanya kesenian, kita memakai kesenian, kita memakai performance art, kita memakai gambar-gambar yang besar, semua masyarakat pasti tertarik. Karena apa? Secara visual yang kami berikan kepada masyarakat itu menghibur. Dan secara propaganda yang kami utarakan kepada masyarakat, masyarakat mengerti.
This active political art is at the very heart of Tarang Padi's work. When Indonesian farmers protested against the use of genetically modified rice strains, forced on them by the International Monetary Fund and their own government, Tarang Padi stepped in. They organised a scarecrow festival in the village of Delanggu, using the scarecrow as a symbol of protest.
Yeah, kalau peristiwa itu mengingatkan waktu sebelum tahun 70-an, itu kan petani-petani giat menanam padi, khususnya padi lokal, dan setiap satu petak itu pasti ada orang-orangan atau memetik sawah itu, dan akhirnya tahun 80-an sampai hampir 2000-an itu hampir hilang.
Karena kita jembatan kita adalah salah satunya adalah memakai Karang Taruna, kelompok pemuda kampung ya, Karang Taruna. Itu yang mempermudah ya, dan masuk dengan tokoh-tokoh masyarakat.
Ketika kami di sana hidup bersama mereka, terus melakukan kerja-kerja, pemikiran itu menjadi berkembang bahwa musuh padi itu ternyata bukan hanya burung, tapi juga lapangan golf, juga pestisida, semikel, terus hotel, tourism. Itu menjadi musuh dari padi.
Itu sangat respon sekali untuk membuat itu. Karena walaupun tempatnya kan agak jauh dari daerah sini sampai daerah sana, itu hanya bergabung menjadi satu.
A total of 40 scarecrows were built, and 500 people from over 25 villages took part.
Dipamerkan di lapangan Koripan ya waktu itu ya. Di sana seperti dinilai ada poin-poin khusus. Oh ini, wah sangat kreatif, ada yang sangat simpel, ada yang mini, ada yang besar, ada yang rumit, pakai konstruksi, pakai tali-tali, seperti itu. Wah.
Nah, di luar pemikiran kami gitu. Nah, kita pikir di sawah ya hanya sederhana, hanya kasih tali, hanya seperti itu. Oh, ternyata mereka membuat hal yang di luar dugaan kami gitu. Wah fantastik.
Setelah festival membedi sawah itu banyak petani juga meniru membuat, contohnya ini banyak yang ada yang banyak ada yang membuat, tapi tidak sebagus seperti yang festival dulu karena festival itu berlomba-lomba bagus ini.
But Tarang Padi's public profile has put them at risk. They've been a target for threats and violence from extreme right-wing groups like the GPK, a militia of predominantly unemployed youth who terrorise pro-democracy supporters.
Recently, you know, our place, our headquarters being attacked by the fundamental Islam. As you can see, all the glass being broken and so on. It is because, you know, they had condemned us as a new emerging communism, as the scum of the earth, simply because, you know, we are look dreadfully horrible and look. And also our way of perceiving the world, you know, is totally anti so-called the fundamentalism.
GPK ini pernah melakukan penyerangan ke sini yang mengakibatkan 5 orang di Taring Padi ini luka-luka, 1 orang limpa ini harus diambil, dan sekarang sampai sekarang setiap bulan harus cuci darah setiap bulan. Itu yang secara fisik yang pernah kami dapatkan.
Along with physical attacks, there've been propaganda attacks.
Mulai muncul rumor bahwa kami adalah termasuk mafia drug gitu ya. Kita adalah produser, gitu. Kemudian kita adalah pusat prostitut, kita melakukan free sex, ya semacam itu. Kemudian kita adalah komunis, itu jelas-jelas merupakan ya itu kesedihan bagi aku ya.
Despite these external pressures and lack of resources, Tarang Padi retains its strong ties with ordinary people and its belief that art has a purpose. Tarang Padi frequently use communal banner making as a way to meet and interact with local people. Each banner focuses on an important local theme and is designed collectively with the villagers.
Very good life. It's tempe. Good.
Oh, enak.
Enak, enak. Very. Delicious.
The Gampingan village banner took 12 Tarang Padi members 8 hours to finish. Once completed, the banner is always donated to the community.
Baliho sejak akhir 98 atau awal 99 itu, karena kita butuh space yang lebih luas itu. Akhirnya kita memilih media yang cukup besar dengan space publik. Karya itu nggak bisa dipasang di dalam ruangan, harus di tempat umum. Selalu menginginkan sebuah karya yang baru secara visual maupun tema, selalu berkembang, selalu menyesuaikan dengan kondisi saat itu.
Since the formation of Tarang Padi, there have been three new governments in Indonesia. However, little has changed in society. So Tarang Padi have continued their ongoing commitment to education and political reform.
Seni bisa menjadi media, bisa menjadi media pembebasan. Seni bisa menjadi media pendidikan. Seni bisa menjadi media propaganda. Dan tidak harus selalu berbicara estetis.
Seni adalah seni. Aku barangkali sitir dari kata-kata Rendra. Apa arti perjuangan bila terpisah dari derita lingkungan? Dan apa artinya berpikir bila terpisah dari masalah kehidupan?
Iya.
Kalau kita keadaan sudah damai, sudah tentram, tidak ada penindasan, kita bisa menggunakan seni untuk senang-senang. Hanya untuk sebuah estetis. Tapi di masa sekarang, kita masih tertindas, masih berjuang, rakyat masih banyak yang bodoh. Reformasi itu hanya slogan. Karena apa saya berani bilang itu? Zaman Soekarno, rakyat ditembaki. Zaman Suharto, rakyat ditembaki. Zaman Habibie, rakyat ditembaki. Zaman Gus Dur, rakyat ditembaki. Dan sekarang zaman Megawati juga ada ditembaki.
Militer punya kekuatan hanya dari senjata, sedangkan kami punya kekuatan dari tekad, semangat. Kami tidak takut dengan senapan, kami tidak takut dengan panser, kami tidak takut dengan bedil dan interogasi, strom dan sebagainya. Itu adalah makanan sehari dari saya.
Jadi Tarang Padi ini seperti laboratorium yang belum selesai bekerja. Dia masih harus dipukul, harus menggodok, harus memasak terus-menerus. Dia harus bisa menemukan jawabannya.
Sebenarnya secara kesimpulan ya akhirnya tidak bisa seorang perubahan secara ajaib seorang individu itu merubah sesuatu itu tidak bisa. Dia harus punya relasi dengan orang lain.
Tarang Padi harus tetap konsisten lah gitu untuk memperjuangkan dan berpihak kepada rakyat, memperjuangkan kebebasan berekspresi dan rakyat supaya manusia Nusantara itu tetap bisa menjadi bangsa atau rakyat yang mandiri, independen, manusia yang merdeka itu.
Itu yang jelas. Kita sudah siap kok sebenarnya.
Gemuruh mesin pabrik takkan pernah berhenti, seolah menyatu dengan nasib dan daging.
Selamat sore. Untuk film ini dibuat oleh teman Tarang Padi dari Australia tahun 2002. Untuk saya sendiri masih belum bergabung dengan Tarang Padi. Saya gabung dari Tarang Padi tahun 2004. Karena untuk film ini member Tarang Padi generasi pertama, sedangkan saya generasi kedua. Itu ketika Tarang Padi pindah dari Gampingan ke Sewon, Bantul. Kami dari Sanggar Caping join dengan Tarang Padi, akhirnya kita menjadi satu komunitas Tarang Padi. Untuk film berikutnya,
first time is kind of like a movie to introducing how is Tarang Padi we starting, And now it's like because it's kind of like 17 years ago that we starting, and now it's political in Indonesia is changed. It's more complex and more many things we cannot more confuse how the activists or people have interesting to make a society more better is more complex. So, but we still moving and help to the people. It's like this example how we do is like 2 years ago. We go to the some village in the central Java near with the, near the North Sea. So this is like a fisherman village. We go in there. We have they first time they asking to us to join with them to make something in their village. So we interesting because they need something to campaign about their problem in there. So we go in there we discuss and we try to make a something or event in that time. So we go like 1 week, we stay, we eat, we sleep with people in there and listening and working together and many things. So this is kind of like a how daily life they go. Okay, this is kind of like the way they live. Every afternoon they go to the like central space how to sell the fish. So every day they go in the afternoon, go to the sea, put the find a fish, and the morning they put the fish. It's in that era is very rich sea because they have a natural spawn where the fish make a generation in a lot of fish in there. So kind of like every day in a bad season, fishermen in there kind of like have in Indonesia we get in maybe 100 ringgit is every day. Just only short half day they working. It's a bad season, but when the harvest season is a lot of fish, they have more, kind of like in Indonesia, like a million a day they have, because this sea is very rich. But the government will not make something in there. Government try to make exactly that space is conservation area. But the government want to make a coal power plant in there. So the conservation area, they want to choose something or tricking something to how they can make a build something in there. So it's, you know, it's in bureaucracy, we can play a money how to do that. So we come in there, it's kind of daily life, and we come there just only have expression kind of like this. They just make something and just photocopy, put in every house. Just a simple thing. And kind of like this too, cutting the hair. And we go, and especially it's kind of like a taring body have some formula how to go to the village, how to do the native people or something. It's kind of like the our formula is a woodcut printing. We have design, we make a design about their problem because the issue we already talking about that with the people, how the text, how the story or something. So after that, we make a design from woodcut. Sometimes we make a workshop too, let the people make for themselves. But in this time, we make two designs about the coal, against coal power plant. And in the day, it's kind of like a something like a text, kind of like this. I make a short text, Wanigeger is a brief to fight in Javanese. But then this tag is, people in there is like really like this tag, so they kind of like copy to the kind of like this in toys, and some young people make a tag in the wall. So it's kind of like how the tag can inspire people to make do everything they like. And the t-shirts. And so this is design how we print it in the t-shirt. In that time is, for me, it's very amazing time because when we just only make a sample how to print, maybe two times, and then they do by themselves how print it in the t-shirt. So they bring all t-shirt in their house, come and print it. Every people come, kids, mothers, young people, every t-shirt in there print it in that time. So it's kind of like we starting after auction feast, it's kind of like they stop in the, okay, we start in the 7 in the night, and they stopping until 3 or 4 a.m. in the morning. So they print every day. So it's, wow, this is more amazing for me. This is another designs. Yeah, this is print. And this is mother, how the mothers printed their t-shirt, print by themselves, because we print it stepping on the block. Just only manual, every people can do. So they can enjoy, they have experience how to print it by themselves. And then another formula for us is like a paint. We bring paint and brush. This is important because paint and brush and sometimes with the cardboard, recycled cardboard is X something. Because not every day fishermen using or playing paint. So when we bring something and we is like facilitating something, is they find new thing to do something new for their life. It's very fun. So every people in that time, kids, mothers, fathers, they join to how to make something in the carpet with paint, playing paint. They playing color. And another, we try to make a mural in the auction space. They confuse how the people make something in there. Starting mural. We do everything in here only 1 week. So when we make mural, we just making sketch, only we sketch together with the people in there how they need, how the text they wanna need, and what we should be put in the picture. So after that we try make a sketch in the wall, and then people helping how to making color. This is the simple thing. I want this color. This you, they're free to make to give a color in the sketch. So everybody, every people can join. And this is the mural is finished. In the auction house, they use this space every day, starting the 2 p.m. until 5 or 6. And this is the kids, fathers, they, this is for me, we bring some many cardboard in that time, but so we need to keep it for us because we still need for something in that time, because they really want to make everything, the cardboard we bring to make something. They is kind of like a crazy to make playing with the very fun with the using painting. Some interesting, this is their artwork. They don't, they never make a painting. They never just try in the time. Just we just facilitate to do that. Yeah, this is some example of what they need. Yeah, especially the cardboard, we something we kind of like we call it the cardboard puppet. We use this when we have demonstration in Indonesia or in Jogja or Jakarta or in another city in Indonesia. We make this cardboard puppet for make yeah, it's kind of like art, and but we just kind of like how make the issue text in there. So sometimes it's very useful for us because when really hot, we can hiding under this, under that. And sometimes we just prepare to something what really bad happen. We can use that as tools for fight. Because we're using bamboo in there. And in that time, we try to collect many prey for the people around there. You know, this is kind of like Tibetan people making something. So we share, we give many fabric to the people and making how they pray about their land. So this is like example, because, and after that we put in the booth. And this is it's kind of like tomorrow afternoon we starting going to make a demonstration or a kind of demonstration. It's kind of like a carnival in that village. So in the net I try to make in something because it's already planned. Before I make from bamboo construction, but it's not enough time, so I try to make this. But people are very confused. What are you doing? I want to make a dragon in that time. So what kind of dragon from cardboard? But they enjoy to know the process and really help him. What can I do to help this dragon happen? Yeah, this is really hot. You can hiding under. Because in that time we have a connection with another community like Greenpeace in that time. and they make a photo op. And this is starting by the banner too. We make carnival two times. First time in the field, rice field, because rice field is where it's the building of four plant they want to build, they want to make in the rice field. Rice field is very, is still people farming in there every day. They live in there until now, but it's like a productive land, but government don't care about that. So they want to take that land. And this is the many prey what they writing in the fabric. So we hope when the wind going, so the prey will be spare way, and some energy maybe can respect. This is from Put. Skit. And we after last in the end of this event or the call it event, we make some culture night with the people. So we establish many artwork. They make like make a small exhibition in the auction space, screening movies and singing music, kind of like, because another the third formula is from Tarik Badi. Second one is the woodblock print. Second is like a paint and cardboard, and third is music. Music is important because we share our music to the people, because maybe painting or something they will be gone, but the kids, when we share our music, they will be remember our music always. So when after now they always asking us how to come and playing music again, but they still remember the music. We do kind like this in many places in Java, especially in Java and some island in Indonesia. This is after that they showing how to learn the music after our workshop. See. This is workshop in the night. You can see many, all people come. And we make a short movies about that.
Oh. semua bubar nggak mau datang situ. Misalnya carinya paling setengah jam, berapa jam, paling tidak kalau sudah ada PLTU paling tidak 2 jam.
Yeah, this is 2 years ago. We go to that village. But maybe people, how to happen right now? is, you know, is government is they kind like a bebal gitu ya. They don't care how this happen. The important thing, the big project must be go on. So this is it's kind of like what happened now in that village. They ever come again to our space to still make more solid solid solidarity with us, to asking we if they need something or help, we ready to help. Yeah, we discuss about that in our space in Taring Padi. They come to the Taring Padi after that event too. And that's what really happened there then. They feel they make a giving sing. They close this area. So the farmer cannot go into the farm again. But because the land still, some farmers still have land in there. Not every land there sell. So some farmers still have land, but the farm is daily left for them, for their farmer. They close that land. So when they want to go into farm, they go kind of like that now. But they still, yeah, they're still strong. I know, you know, people in the village, they have a power and they have good spirit. Until now, they still fight against the coal power plant. They every day going to the farm is kind of like this. And they make some event against, and they try to make some tent. It's like inspiring from another movement in Central Java against cement factory, where they make a tent, and they make a tent too near with the fields. This is what happened now in that area. They're still making something with cardboard and paint. And we have more demonstration in Jakarta. Okay. And we have some opportunity going to the Japan. Because the big investor is from Japan, so when I go to the Japan, I have solo show and I have opportunity to meet some friend in Japan, especially from IRA. We try to make a solidarity for people from Japan, how they support our movement in Java. So this is what the activity in there. Showing the movies, print. This is another design about that, because more international, so I put English language. Black coal, dark energy. Yeah, and the movement still going on until now. You know, Indonesia is environmental issue is really big issue now, because we have a lot of resources and a lot of money will be more come to Indonesia to change our resources with money. It's not valuable, you know. It's resources is more than money. Because when they destroy that sea, we have a lot of many species. This is not about money, this is about many things in our human life we need it. Okay, this is what is Tareng Padi now. So, I don't know, yeah. Eight. This is a little bit movie about another movement. It's a short movie.
Cukil, tujuannya buat agar masyarakat juga bisa memilih, karena banyak janji-janji yang dari partai-partai atau caleg-caleg, jadi kita kasih pilihan buat masyarakat, jadi bisa ngerti apa yang mereka inginkan gitu.
Karya kawan-kawan Tareng Padi, street art kawan-kawan Tareng Padi tentang menyikapi pemilu 2014. Isu yang pertama adalah tentang pendidikan politik untuk rakyat. Yang kedua adalah tuntutan rakyat.
Poster ini merupakan penyikapan kita terhadap pemilu saat ini, dan merupakan tema-tema tentang ada buruh, petani, dan beberapa tema lainnya seperti HAM, dan merupakan pendidikan politik bagi masyarakat.
Sebagai media pendidikan politik untuk menyampaikan aspirasi dan mengkritisi pemilu itu sendiri. Semua itu kami diskusikan bersama, setelah itu baru pembuatan sketch, dan waktu itu teknik yang kami pakai adalah cukil kayu, dan kemudian sekarang diaplikasikan ke dalam print, dan kami harapkan melalui poster ini juga bisa dimengerti oleh semua kalangan.
untuk video yang barusan, ide awal kita teman-teman Taring Padi untuk pembuatan poster itu sebenarnya dengan menyikapi kita election tahun 2014. Setiap member mempunyai satu ide tema. Waktu itu saya hukum untuk tema itu. Kalau Ucup nggak salah tentang petani ya.
Politik
dinasti. Jadi setiap kita coba membuat karya itu, kita diskusikan bersama teman-teman, kawan-kawan, bagaimana ide itu. Ketika ide itu sudah cocok dengan tema-tema untuk election, kita cukil bersama, woodcut bersama, cetak bersama, dan kita tempel ke beberapa spot yang ada di Jogja khususnya, dan ada juga dikirim ke beberapa kota di Indonesia. Untuk tema poster itu ada sekitar 22 tema, diantaranya buruh, worker, petani, tentang dinasti politik, tentang pendidikan, transportasi. Kita coba semua belajar dari itu dan coba share ke masyarakat untuk pendidikan politik waktu pemilu 2014. Seperti itu. Terima kasih.
Oke, aku pikir cukuplah kita, kami yang ada duduk berdua di sini membagi sesuatu. Mungkin ada kawan-kawan yang lain yang mau membagi atau mau apalah, mau bertanya, mau membagi, mau merespon, mau menambahkan, kamu Tarik Padi kurang begini, it's okay for me. Because we open, because now is Tarik Padi try to open with many alternative idea, because you know it's complexities problem in many country. I talked with Risa yesterday, every country have serious problem now. So what's next with us? Well, we care with this, with our country, how to make a better life people in our country. We thought operation and respect to human right and environmental. Okay, maybe.
All right, there's a presentation from Taring Padi, Yunan and Ucup. Give a big hand for them for the really good presentation. So now we open for a question, which is a Q&A session. So anybody have some things to ask them?
Satu ya. Yang Yunan generasi 3. Jadi sekarang ada berapa di kelompoknya?
We are very confused with that, Pak. Because before in Taring Padi we have like a structure and we have member when it's like a surely member of Taring Padi. But since 2002 we change a lot because tight organization is not open with people because we have kind like a stigma, is kind like a communism or something. Is not better we to open with share with many people because people still afraid with that kind. You know, because 32 years is not good. So after we told it's like a first generation and the second generation. So after the first generation, we don't know the time. Every people can come and go in that time. So it's kind we I call second generation. Maybe some friend come, second generation, because the first generation maybe still one or two still stay. But it's kind of like that.
Tapi si Icul sama si Tony enggak lagi kan? Generasi barunya?
Tony masih. And Icul is first generation. And yeah, we still have contact with something sometimes, kind of like that. Because it's now it's kind of like a family in Taring Padi, because yeah, we try more open, and not many activity like before. We just try to look into more deeply first, because we know the reality issue or political in Indonesia. So we try to not always like more reactionary about something.
All guys?
No, you know, it's like a Fitri. Yeah, Gina. It look like a many, yeah. It's, sometimes it's many male, but we have a female to join with us. Because us, kind of like some friend is not basically from artists. They like a Gina, he study in theology or something, and they don't have a like a skill before how to make a painting or something or creative in art. But when we working together, he starting from giving color or something. This is the new starting, and then have respect and try to make something too. So, but sometimes we share, because you know, artist is kind of like we very bad for make an organization or make a formal things. So some friend can help to do something and that.
How many members altogether?
We have some meeting. We call it some two times, like a Senenan and Jumatan. So every Senen in the night, every Monday in the night we meet, or Friday in the night we meet. But yeah, we have, you know, it's more easy. We have WhatsApp or something, like it's more easier. We not always come meeting. We just can discuss in the.
Saya mau menambahkan yang Pak untuk generasi pertama itu, karena waktu itu Taring Padi punya struktur, ada presiden, sekjen, bagian apa? Ini termasuk presiden kedua setelah Tony. Nah, waktu tahun 2002 baru kita coba diskusi, akhirnya Taring Padi membuka ruang komunitas, jadi komunitas seperti itu.
Enggak ada, Pak. Karena waktu itu bertepatan we moving from the squad. The squad that the government are taking the squad before we together in one space. And that time we must peer a different space. Many friends gave rent another space. So how to do that? Yeah, we don't have no structure. We just have a space to meet, and every day some friend they have respect, they go every day to that space to meet, to coordinating something. Yeah.
Ada syarat-syarat tak untuk menyertai Taring Padi? Contohnya, kalau ada artis yang berminat untuk join Taring Padi tapi kemahiran dia bukan dalam seni woodcut. Yeah. Ya. Ada tak macam proses apa tu pemilihan dari segi kemahiran dia ke, dari medium dia ke? Ada tak syarat-syarat macam tu? Dan kalau tak ada, pernah tak ada masalah di mana artis nak menyertai Taring Padi tetapi tak tahulah, mungkin kualiti seni dia tak setaraf atau tak sepadan dengan karya-karya Taring Padi yang lain?
We open for every people. Every people, they don't have any skill to with art or something, we open. With the condition, they're interesting and have respect with our ideas, our mission to helping people to helping people and environmental kind of like that. So we don't care, you don't have any skill, if you come you can join and you can help me. Important thing kind of like that. You join but you cannot do you just stay and it's not working. So if you can join and when we have something, it's like a working something or event or something or any ideas we want to doing and you join, you can help in many ways you like, you can do kind of like that. If you we have bad in the kind of like a formal thing like making letter or email, answering email or something, this which artists in Jogja especially for me is really bad to do that lah. Yeah, it's, you can some people helping to do that, this is important.
Seperti ada teman-teman artis juga di bidang musik contohnya, terus performance art, dia bisa join ke Taring Padi. Seperti contohnya saya basicnya sebenarnya sekolah hukum, nggak bisa bergambar sama sekali tadinya. Saya tertarik dengan Taring Padi karena ide-idenya yang liar, gila. Dia coba floorkan isu-isu masyarakat, tentang masyarakat. Saya akhirnya bergabung dengan Taring Padi dan akhirnya bisa ikut join sampai sekarang.
One example, we ever make some event in the East Java. We try to helping people that have case like a mud disaster in East Java, in Sidoarjo. It's like maybe 20 village going down with the mud, hot mud, because of mining. So we go there and we need some money to have event in there. So we make like a charity night. We try to invite many friends. They have many different skill of us. Performing, performer, tattoo artist, sketching face, melukis wajah, and merchandise, or even parking people. We try to collect money in there. We invited people to come in that event and maybe buy our merchandise, buy our artwork, because in that time we make an exhibition. Maybe they want to make a tattoo because our friend in tattoo, okay, I respect with your event because you helping people. I'm making tattoo and the money, and when people pay me to make tattoo, the money I give to you this event. It's kind of like that. So when the people interesting with, I just join how they can do for us, or how they can do to the ideas of Taring Padi really happen in many ways. Because we try to support people when the people oppression by state or fascist, kind of like that.
Actually, I'm quite keen to further explore that line of questioning. I think what she means, and I'm also quite interested to find out about this, is I understand that you accept members of different, you know, different skill sets, you know, different mediums and all. But I think what's very evident in Taring Padi's work is that there's a very clear aesthetic. And I'm wondering, like, you know, like maybe that's also what she's wondering, whether when someone comes into Taring Padi with a very different sort of aesthetic, has that been a problem or has that happened before, or I just like...
We never have problem with that. We never have problem because some new friends come, they just only interesting, just first time they just watching me. And then helping to giving color. Giving color is simple, only kid they can do. yeah, kids can do. When and then more big space, more give smell, maybe bark in the when we make a in the flower or something, just making small bark in there. They're starting for that. And we don't, you know, Taring Padi, we don't say always with aesthetic, because exactly Taring Padi living in the two ways, one in activism, one in the artwork. But we this is more confused to us too. We don't really working in the art world, but we more working in the activism. This is different. But in the activism, people don't really think about the real beautiful aesthetic. People don't judge the aesthetic. People just how to know the message in the art. Just simple kind like that.
Yeah, I mean, sorry, just to because I kind of realized that when it comes to the archives and, you know, what goes into Taring Padi's catalog of works and archive of works, you know, this is generally a very uniform aesthetic. So which I was asking, like why don't, you know, like other forms of sort of, you know, aesthetics enter into the archives of Taring Padi, if, you know, if there has been different members who have come in with different styles and all, but it seems quite uniformity.
Yeah.
If that makes sense, yeah.
Yeah, it's just because we have same form, kind of like that.
Straucho.
Yeah.
Tadi saya sebut berkenaan dengan gerakan seni rupa baru yang dianggap sebagai mewakili semangat zamannya. Apakah Taring Padi boleh dianggap sebagai mewakili zeitgeist ataupun semangat zamannya? Soalan yang kedua, tiga sebenarnya. Soalan yang kedua, Taring Padi telah bertahan. Saya mula melihat gantungannya dalam tahun 1990-an di Jogja. Dan sampai hari ini saya lihat dia masih lagi berterusan. Jadi apakah landas yang memungkinkan kelompok Taring Padi ini bertahan sekian lama? Kerana biasanya kelompok, grup ataupun komuniti atau komunitas tidak boleh bertahan lama. Soalan ketiga berkait dengan soalan yang kedua. Apatah lagi memandangkan Surah Ucuk juga ada menyebut bahawa harapan di peringkat awal sewaktu berkelompok ternyata kemudiannya tidak terrealisasi seutuhnya. Apakah berbekalkan landas yang sedemikian, you can still carry on, you can still go on and have the passion and even the drive to the extent that, in relation to your most recent answer, that for you and your friends, perhaps if I do not misinterpret you, kalau saya tidak silap tafsir, bahawa bagi anda sekalian, bahawa pengisian ataupun message ini itu paling kurangnya tidak kurang pentingnya daripada estetikanya, malah kadang-kadang mungkin mengatasi dari segi estetikanya. Terima kasih.
Ya, terima kasih. Kalau when Taring Padi is like a is kind like a zeitgeist, semangat zaman, aku pikir kalau saya ditanya secara personal, ya, saya adalah semangat zaman di zaman saya. Saya memiliki semangat. This meaning I have spirit and power how to know and care about my country. We criticize my country. It's not about I hate my country. This is I love my country with another side. We just know, not using government eyes. We just people eyes, because let the government know many perspectives about this country. So this is semangat zaman. I think for a young generation, so we have to show the semangat zaman and know the condition, the real condition. not only reaction, just try to know the real know how to make this country more better for the people. And for, yeah, we already 17 years, and it's a lot many happen in our community. We going out from the squad, maybe 1 year we stopping not to do something because we try to build our new space, just only working, painting the wall, fixing the roof, kind of like that. It's okay for us because we not always show like to the people our activism. We just should be care our about ourselves, how to survive, how we stay, and kind of like after 2006, our space is falling down with the earthquake. We moving to the another space and build new space until now, and this is our established space because we buy that land from we selling artwork. Because we have product, yeah, we have merchandise, we can do something, we can make exhibition, people interesting with our art, we can sell, have money, we collect, and we can buy land, and we build some space for us until now. So, yeah, we need some people too strong to keeping the spirit of Taring Padi still stay. I mean, the spirit have solidarity with the people. This is, I mean, the real way for us. Because in many generations we have different spirit. Like me, I have experience about how to falling down the Suharto. But Yunanto, no, they don't have experience. And young generation now, they more different, they more social media generation kind like that. So we try to dialectica, how to understand the every generation to know what they need and what they happen and how to still working together with solidarity with another people, not only for self. Maybe just kind like that.
First of all, congratulations on your amazing work. A few questions on politics. According to mainstream media, democracy is back in Indonesia with the election of Jokowi. So my first question, do you agree? And number two, have you ever endorsed any presidential candidates before or governor candidates? And number three, what are your hopes for your country? What do you see for Indonesia? Is it going to be better? Which we all hope so. And I mean for Malaysia as well. Because we are closely related. Thank you.
Taring Padi is we not following any party. We not endorse, I think it's high political is not our real business, because our real business how to help people. We can see they already oppressed by state, because when we following the political of high, this is like stupidity. Yeah, we know this is stupid. Well, how we always following that? Which better we make our ways how to make better, not following that issue. For me, kind of like that. And for me, for our country, it's kind of like we understand our perspective about our country. Because you know, after colonialism in our country, everything is changed. We always in Western thing, rational thing coming, scientists coming, we losing many things in that time because colonialism. So we try to find, how our own perspective with the our country, because our country is different, our resources is different, our land is different, our weather is different. It's many, many things, we losing something, many indigenous local genius is lost after that. Yeah, in colonialism kind of like a giving, bring us rational thing. But in daily life, in our people, we don't care rational or irrational thing. We don't care. They can fly, it's okay. They can go everywhere, but it's okay. We have any sign kind of like that, but we're losing that time. We have a lot before, but sometimes happen. So we should be find how the character our country and know the perspective for future. Better or not better is about taste for me. It's about taste. I feel better when I really know and I feeling better when I see some, because for me kind of like this, art cannot change everything. Art cannot change. The art just giving inspiration to the people to change the condition. Just giving inspiration to the people. So when we look some people inspiring by us, it's feeling me is I'm lucky. I'm feeling better. I'm like a success for something. So this is a, we don't have value, the real value, how the successful of art.
Okay, aku ada soalan tentang politik juga. Aku rasa Taring Padi adalah satu contoh di mana kamu sukses untuk menggunakan seni untuk melawan, sebagai alat untuk melawan. Tapi bukan hanya untuk menyuarakan protes, sebab banyak seniman atau artis yang menggunakan seni untuk menyentuh tentang isu-isu politik seperti karya-karya yang dipamer dalam galeri ini. Tapi yang membezakan Taring Padi ialah kamu juga gunakan seni itu untuk sebagai senjata untuk beraktivisme. Kerana kamu juga turun ke jalan terus sama dalam berdemonstrasi dan protes dan juga turun dalam aksi dan juga ke lapangan, ke kampung-kampung. Dari sudut itu kamu sukses untuk gunakan seni untuk menyuarakan bantahan dan protes rakyat. Kamu juga sukses dalam menggunakan seni untuk mengorganize masyarakat. Kamu kata tadi menginspirasi masyarakat untuk bangkit, untuk bangun, untuk bersatu dan melawan seperti contoh yang kamu tunjukkan tadi. Ya, di Bantang, yeah. Di Batang ya, yang untuk melawan the coal mines. So dari aspek itu kamu sukses. Tapi sebagai senjata untuk beraktivisme, selalunya sukses atau tidak dinilai dari aspek adakah kamu sukses untuk betul-betul membawa isu itu ke depan. Sebab kamu sukses untuk membangkitkan kesedaran rakyat tentang kenapa mereka tak patut terima the coal plant. Ya, di situ kamu sukses, rakyat, masyarakat sudah sedar, masyarakat bangun, bangkit dan lawan. Tapi kamu masih gagal untuk mengubah pendirian penguasa. Kamu masih gagal untuk menghentikan coal mine itu untuk terus dijalankan. So dari aspek itu masih gagal. Ya. Dan aku pasti kamu selepas berapa belas tahun kamu kata kamu sudah ada formula bila kamu masuk ke kampung, kamu sudah ada formula untuk menggerakkan rakyat. Tetapi berdasarkan pengalaman kamu, pernahkah ada sukses di mana kamu berjaya untuk mengubah pendirian penguasa, untuk mereka mendengar bantahan rakyat? Sebab aku rasa, ya macam kamu kata juga awal masa presentasi kamu, penguasa ni banyakannya bebal, mereka tak mahu dengar. Di Malaysia juga sama, kita bantah banyak kali, bersuara banyak kali, mereka bebal, tak mahu dengar bantahan dan protes. Jadi soalannya, pernah tak ada sukses? Dan jika pernah, apa yang menyebabkan penguasa mahu mengubah pendirian? Jika tak pernah, ada tak Taring Padi pernah refleksi dan melihat semula strategi bagaimana untuk betul-betul membawa perubahan itu, bukan hanya seni. Sebab ya, itu bezanya seni sebagai jenis suara untuk protes dan seni untuk aktivisme. Sebab matlamat akhir aktivisme ialah untuk membawa perubahan ya dalam masyarakat. Ha, jadi itu soalannya.
Kalau dibicarakan sukses seperti itu, ya belum pernah. Tapi ada satu sukses kecil yang sebenarnya cukup menarik. Look like when we make a scarecrow festival in that Sedelanggu at that time, we try to make government make some rule to people, make a rule to agree people make like organic farming in that time. So because in that, you know, because it's really big issue too before in Suharto era, Suharto giving like a chemical rice farm for the people. So people is like addict with the new rice. So we lost many species of rice. We have a lot, thousand rice species in Indonesia, but now maybe just only 3 or 2. It's from corporated rice. We always buy the seed, buy the pesticida or something. So in the time, in the issue, we try to government give agree people can make a plan organic farming in the time. So we know we call it in there is Bupati. They push the bureaucracy in there to make something, people let the people make organic farming. This is a small thing, this is not real big about success. The successful is about how change the country, not only by Taring Padi. Not always by Taring Padi. We just, you know, Taring Padi meaning, Taring Padi is like a, you know, it's like a bulu di padi. In every rice, they have a small, yeah, this seed, ikan ya, bulu kecil. They should be fly. So we fly, and we put in your skin is make itchy. So it's Taring Padi, it's a small thing, but just enough to make itchy. This is Taring Padi philosophy. We not make some big movement, change something. No. We if kind like that, we should be make a party or something, because many question from many friends in Indonesia how to make a Taring Padi in another city. We don't know. Please make your own style. We just inspiring you. Just make your own style. You know your local condition. Try to find something in there. We just open kind of like that. So it's second time with Taring Padi philosophy. This bulu ini juga untuk memperbanyak padi, dia sebagai penyerbukan, menyerbuk padi lain untuk bertambah banyak. That's the meaning of Taring Padi.
Okay, soalan kedua saya. Apa proses membuat keputusan dalam Taring Padi? Contohnya, isu-isu masyarakat ni banyak, tapi macam mana Taring Padi memilih isu yang hendak dibawa? Adakah apa prosesnya? Adakah perlu mencapai konsensus daripada semua ahli Taring Padi untuk kita sama-sama memperjuangkan isu ini daripada banyak isu yang lain? Apa prosesnya?
Untuk pemilihan isu di teman-teman Taring Padi, kita ketuanya itu Senin dan Jumat. Setiap hari Senin dan Jumat kita coba diskusi dengan beberapa teman-teman, dan akhirnya ketemu isu itu kita olah sampai belum buat karya, kita olah terus, kita poin-poin apa yang isu itu, poin-poin apa, dan akhirnya kita rumuskan, kita buat karya, entah itu cukil kayu atau painting atau sculpture, ya.
Yeah. It's a depend itu. the condition.
Yeah,
condition. It's depend the condition. If the we need to make something, it's kind like a making artwork. We discuss about the issue, what the issue we need it, and what the we find the big theme, what the big theme about the issue. And then we discuss how to make detailing the theme. It's kind of like same like the election poster. Mm. Okay, this issue is about election. What the details? What we needed with this election? Okay, we need a cheaper healthy care. We need a cheap education. We need safe transportation. We need a farmer have land, kind of like that. We have justice in law, the real justice in law. We try detailing, and we discuss every detail, how to make, until we find the text, what the short text and nice text in there. So this is kind of like this. This is it's deepened the condition or something. Some people come. We have problem, we have this issue, can you help me? We look and we have time, we have, okay, we go. Kind of like that. Just different the condition. Or some people have kind of like a inspiration. Okay, I do something, but I responsibility to the Taring Padi. Because I bring name of Taring Padi, what I do is to be have Taring Padi mission and like that. We don't breaking the law how the Taring Padi respect to. I mean, like I'm a personal, I go to something, and I have my decision. Okay, it's Taring Padi will follow. So we have responsibility to the Taring Padi. If Taring Padi some friend not can join, as person, I shall be responsible as Taring Padi. Kind of like that.
Okay, this next section.
Yeah, since you've been active for 17 years, how do you do with the archiving your many works? Like, you published one book 2011, but also how do you maintain with all the woodcut and the posters and many, many small patches and all these designs? Can you tell me how you take care of all the artworks or archiving?
We're really bad for that. Really, really bad. You know, we are community, we are independent. We don't have money, we just something selling poster or do something, we should be pay list, electric or water or something. So, as person in Taring Padi, they work by themselves, as artists too, sometimes. So in Taring Padi to archive something is, we don't care about that. It's not important issue from in Taring Padi, maybe kind of like that. So, but in that time when we make a book, it's very, wow, this is a, it's horrible how to find this many, many thing in Taring Padi. So we try to contact many friends. When we remember they have a documentation or something, we try to contact many friends in that time. You have Taring Padi documentation, please send us. We explain how we try to make a book, we try kind like this, we want to share our experience to the people. This is the important thing, why we agree how to make that book. So it's many crime from sometimes late, it's okay. Yes, luckily it's happened. But if you come to Taring Padi and asking, where's the Taring Padi archive? Oh my God, it's very difficult to just maybe have something small, it's still okay. But the real archive of Taring Padi, oh no, it's really, really bad because we moved to moving that time and every Taring, now in Taring Padi is volunteer. We not pay in Taring Padi. We just solidarity to join with Taring Padi. So this is like how to you really respect with Taring Padi. Just solidarity, real solidarity. Just kind of like that. And luckily we still stay. Okay. We closing with the playing Taring Padi songs. Yeah. Sometimes we make workshop to the people and this song is many. Some friends make or Taring Padi make this song. It's for me so far is okay with Taring Padi. Yeah, we playing. This is the song, belajar sama-sama. Petani lah, lagu kedua, petani.
Menguning petani mulai panen, menuai padi penuh harapan. Biar anak-anak negeri bisa makan, rakyat kenyang, semua sejahtera. Tapi kenyataannya sangatlah berbeda. Harga gabah murah, pupuk mahal semua. Petani tetap miskin dan menderita. Ha, petaniku sayang, petaniku malang. Petaniku sayang, petaniku malang. Jangan hanya diam saja, adanya. Petani harus bangkit dan melawan. Hentikan monopoli harga gabah. Hentikan pemakaian pupuk kimia. Hentuskan sistem kepemilikan tanah. Na 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 na.
Oke, petani. Lagu terakhir.
Apa judulnya? Mars Pekerja Seni.
Lagu terakhir ini Mars Pekerja Seni.
Bangkitlah pekerja seni budaya, bergerak bersama rakyat terdindas. Songsonglah fajar yang merah cemerlang, bersatulah semua. Hancurkan nilai budaya palsu, bangun tatanan budaya baru. Dengarlah seruan suara masa, ikuti panggilan sejarah. Giat bekerja, giat berkarya, angkat penamu, sapukanlah kuasmu. Kabarkan perubahan segera datang, dan revolusi kebudayaan. Satukan tekad kita, menuju esok yang lebih baik. Membangun tatanan masyarakat, demokrasi kerakyatan. Membangun tatanan masyarakat, demokrasi kerakyatan.
Terima kasih. For Tareng, Yunan and Ucho for the beautiful presentation.